GF Design Studios. I won't explain the German name because it's just a short form for the German name of our company. We are like four equal partners, as you can see. Easily see that's me, that's our associate Eric. This is also associate Garrett, this is Eric, and this is Sebastian.
Of course, we took pictures. And if you see this typical Indian scene from the street, there's something which we find important, and it is this. This is, of course, the plastic bags, which are everywhere. And you don't only see them everywhere, you see them everywhere. Because they have a way of their life of their own, they go everywhere, and we know that's a problem. We know there's a lot of plastic bags produced every year. We were saying 1 billion, and then we found out between Germans and Indians, we don't even mean the same thing when we talk about a billion. That's why we tried to translate it into Indian crore. And I even found online, I found something called an Arab. Do you use this? Yes. So we talk about one Arab of plastic bags. And then only the production causes, again, we didn't. In this time, we didn't translate it into crore. You have to do it, you're probably better at it than I am. A lot of production causes lots and lots of carbon dioxide, and we all know what this does. And then we know, again, it happens more carbon dioxide during the burning, but only 1 of 10 bags is recycled, is gotten back to be burned, which is bad too, but let's concentrate on the other 9 out of 10, which go everywhere. They go everywhere and they stay there, and they stay there for a long time. Because, as smart people pointed out to us, they do get broken down, and there'll be a decomposition over the time, but it does take a long time. If it does decomposition over time, it poisons the earth while doing so. So this is not a good thing, however. And we know it takes oil to produce plastic bags. I want to put this example for you. Maybe it takes too long, but it's very important for us to think this through one time. It takes lots of oil to produce it. And this is, of course, a resource we don't have endless amounts of. So it's a real waste to take oil, produce plastic bags, it away and have another bigger problem even then. And we have this problem because the stuff doesn't go away. It'll be there, it'll be everywhere. It'll be on your streets, and it'll be in your water. And then we'll have another problem, because being in the water, it'll go on traveling to the oceans. I don't know how many of you have heard of the global Great Pacific garbage patch, which means that there is a place where the currents in the ocean, they tend to gather all the plastic that gets into the oceans. There are several, this is the big one. And you must imagine, you know, it looks a little bit like this. And you can Google it and find out more about it, but it's huge, it's big. It's like 650,000 square kilometers. So we tried to put this into perspective for people in India, and it's about this size. You probably can relate better how big this is, but this is a lot of plastic swirling around in our oceans. What happens? Animals eat it, and birds do so too, and you can find lots and lots of pictures of birds who have died from eating too much plastic. They look like this. They have all these lighters, lighting, you know, and plastic drink bottles in their belly, and they die from it. And there's a lot of this. And also there's something else happening, just to shock you, to know we have a real problem. It's not for the kind of laugh. But this is what happens if a small turtle gets tangled up in some rubbish, and it keeps on growing, you know, it can't grow where the rubbish is, so it will grow up to look like this. And now, the idea how this comes to happen is because of very fundamental way we think about materials. And the funny thing is, I talk about a very Western way to think about materials. We think about taking something, making something, and throwing it away. It's like the take, make, waste kind of idea how stuff lives and works. This finds its way when we, in conventional sustainability, we talk about from the cradle to the grave, we have to look at the thing from the cradle to the grave, how it was produced, how it lived, and how it was put to the grave. And this is the end. This is what I feel in India and the entire region. We have a big chance to have a different outlook on material production, because maybe a way of thinking is so different that you can do actually better, that you can do much better. Because this way of thinking from the cradle to the grave is a very European way to think about life, actually. I hope I found the right picture. We felt like the Indian way is a more circular way of looking at stuff. So this is what I suppose to be the wheel of life, and it has, I hope, we took the real picture to say this cradle to the grave idea, it's old, it's European, it's not the right way. With even an older maybe idea of, from the wheel of life, you're much better suited to get problems, to get a handle on problems. And this is actually what circular economy is about the idea of thinking differently and using materials in circles. And that is actually the reason why we have this logo to the entire thing. You know, I'll do this very briefly. We're doing workshops over several days to explain it in depth, but we wanted you to understand what this is talking about, because a different way of thinking, because it means you have to look at the material, and all the material that can be reused in the natural circle, the natural biosphere, the one green here, should do this. It could go back to nature, and you can retake it from nature. And all the material we take from nature and work upon so much we cannot put it back, it needs to be kept out of nature once taken in an endless circle. So in the moment, in that moment where you need both in one product, or several of one in one product, you always, I'll go there to explain it. You always have to think about how do you put it together, what we usually do as designers, how does the product work, and how can we take that apart again, so we can return nature's material to nature, and the materials we have processed so extreme that we cannot put it back. We have to get them, all of them back. They're not supposed to be here, like a plastic bag, like lots of stuff we put in. They're not supposed to be here. We need to get them back and do new stuff with this. The idea, as I explained it, works very well. But just to illustrate the problem, we have, of course, a problem if we have trash mixed in, intermingled. Because, of course, what you can imagine, he puts water in it, he gets all his clay back, but there's all this plastic in between. So he cannot make new cups out of it as easily as he could have if it would have been kept separated. So this is basically one of the big ideas about a cradle-to-cradle design, which we're so enthusiastic about. There's more, of course, which I don't want to get into, because I find for a product designer the circular aspect is very important. But I'll talk a little slower now, so you have time to read this. I don't have to read this for you. This is all important and part of the entire thing because it's a very holistic way to think about production.
It's always like that. All these technical questions we have been talking out with our partner, the EPEA, and as we are designers, we just, you know, we research it and we bring it to a form and we do a concept, but as soon as it got to production or to all these numbers, we ask people who actually know about that, right? So,
so actually you can, if you're interested in this and want to see what has already been done, which was certified to this standard, international standard, you can go to c2ccertified.org. You can Google it, it shouldn't be a problem. And you'll see the registry with all the stuff. We just wanted, we were asked a lot when we talk about this to show some examples. So we just wanted to show you some examples, what has already been done in a way that is at least first steps into this kind of production. It's not always perfect best practices, but it's always a step and promising to take it better, to take it further and getting better and better.
And to we are very glad to be here, and we have to thank the Goethe-Zentrum and the Association for Design, Architecture and Design India as well, because we did a 3 days workshop over here in Hyderabad with young professionals and students on the topic design for circular economy.